talking about. You know that I just realized, I think you never told me, I'm just going to share my screen. You never told me that you shared those messages, and I was, you know, I've never worked with this standard before. I don't know, can you see my screen?
Yes, I can.
Yeah, so I've never really worked with the DICOM standard, right? So what I did is I downloaded some of the, I downloaded the what I think it's a series or something corresponding to this.
Okay.
This patient here.
Uh-huh.
And after I did that, I got really interested. I've become really interested in this, and I found myself looking up this standard. It turns out, right? And I don't know if you can do this in tools like. I think you should be able to do this, but it's just that it's a lot easier when you're scripting in tools like the Oasis tool that you've been using here.
Uh-huh.
But what I discovered, right, is that observe. What I discovered is that What I discovered is that you can actually easily parse these documents, right? So let me just showcase something here.
Okay.
When you parse these documents, turns out that there's a wealth of information, and I was really suspecting that the meta information is embedded in the document. But observe, I don't know if you're already aware of this, but I've been looking up the standard, and it turns out that what you have access to is rich information such as this, what you're seeing here. Right? So
yeah.
each image or each series of images is embedded with a rich data set of information.
Yeah.
Ranging from, so it ranges from, if you notice here, it ranges from the type of equipment that was used, right?
Yes.
I don't know if most of these things make sense here, but including details to do with the date when
the study was done.
I don't know what the difference is between the study date and acquisition date. I'd have to look this up, including the time as well, right? So the
yes.
study time, the series time, the acquisition time, the type of modality. So
yes.
So if you have a series of, like, a number of documents, what you could do that are taken from different modalities, you can easily figure out where it's coming from.
Okay.
Of course, it turns out that some information like institutional details, I think these details are not properly specified or configured on the machine. So if you look at this institution name, it just says series number 96711. I don't know, maybe there's something unique about this series number. Maybe it corresponds to UTH or something.
Actually, you see, I was looking at one case just this afternoon.
Yeah.
A patient from pediatric ICU. And
okay.
There was something strange that I saw on the CT number, because we usually write on the report the CT number. Instead
okay.
of the usual CT number that we see, there was this same number you are showing me now, 96711.
Oh.
Yeah, so probably in this is a, maybe the institution.
It's an internal code or something.
CDH, Cancer Disease Hospital, maybe.
Mm.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I reluctantly put that number, CT number, but I wasn't sure because it just popped up in an area where we usually put the CT number. And for some reason, it didn't make sense to me because those numbers come as a serial number.
But you notice that there's also other important information like the institutional address. I mean, of course, again, I don't think the machine is properly configured. If you look at this value here, it says there's supposed to be the street and the city district as well,
yeah.
but we only have a ZM for the country, which is Zambia. Right?
Zambia, yes.
But this is, in my opinion, this is all rich information that if you are, let's say, implementing some image repository, you can automatically extract this information, right?
And then that part I'm seeing where it's saying admitting diagnosis description, lung malignancy.
Yeah. So you notice even this thing here, referring physician
name. Yeah.
But I guess the people that take these things don't perhaps they don't apply enter. Some information.
Yeah.
Yeah. So study description as well.
Yeah.
Operator name. This is unfortunate. I suppose it requires someone to log in for them to operate the machine. So
yeah. So the
generic username, I guess.
Radiographer who performs the scan. And this is something that we have always been crying about, because we've been telling them that even on the request form, after you have finished the examination, you put your name there. Sometimes there are problems that you spot in the technique, the manner it was taken, and you want to get back to them and, you know, advise them to say, you know, there was a problem here, and you actually try to see whether you can, you know, help them improve, and they never do that, so it will come back without seeing who did the scan. So it becomes a challenge. You can't follow up when there's a problem. You can't really, you know who actually did who operated the machine. So it shows here that there's a place where they should enter their name.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so including what you are mentioning here, I don't know what this means, admitting the diagnosis description.
So that is on the request form, the doctor is, when they request for a scan, they're supposed to tell us what their suspicion is. So this is what they suspect clinically. When they examine the patient, they suspect lung malignancy or lung cancer. That malignancy simply means cancer.
Okay.
Yeah. So they suspected lung cancer, and that was the reason for them to request for a CT scan to be done to confirm.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then of course you have the other, I guess, what you might consider important information. So patient details, right? The name, the date of birth, the sex, the age. And this is the stuff that you normally see when you open this in that DICOM viewer, right?
Yes.
Extracted from the document itself.
Yeah. And even the parameters are for the scan. You can see there how much kilovoltage was given, the slice thickness.
Where is the kilovoltage here?
That KVP. Just next to where you have highlighted slice thickness, the KVP.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. That is very useful stuff.
Yeah, so I thought it was really interesting, because the beauty with something like this, I mean, if you're implementing an image repository, if you look at it from the perspective of descriptive information about the image, because remember, when you open this thing up into the DICOM viewer, your interest for the most part is the image, right?
Yes.
But ultimately, if you want to effectively retrieve information, there's some there's descriptive information that you might need to associate to the images. So perhaps you might want to search in the repository by username or by description, right? The description of the admitting diagnosis or something, or perhaps by patient ID. So this information becomes useful. And so I thought, I was surprised. I wasn't expecting, I mean, I was expecting that there'll be information embedded in the document, but in the DICOM file itself, but I wasn't, I didn't know that it would be this comprehensive anyway.
Okay. Yeah. I never knew also that actually all this information is present there.